Good morning, students. Yesterday we discussed about some basic points, that is matter and classification of matter, elements, how many elements are present. There are total 118 elements are there, out of which 92 elements are natural elements. Okay, out of this 92 elements, 70 elements are metals and 22 elements are non-metals. Okay, so today we will start the next point, that is the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Now, what is the physical properties? Now, physical properties, chemical properties of metals and non-metals also there. So, first we will do the detailed study about the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So, first physical properties that we will see with physical state. Now, physical state, do you know states? Okay, solid, liquid, gases. Okay, so in which state these metals and non-metals are occurs or found? So if you will see, mostly metals are solid state. Example, copper, Ag, Au, means mostly all the metals are in solid state. But there are some exceptions. Now, exceptions means what? Mostly all are in solid. Okay, odd man out, how it is that way. But exception is the Hg. Now, Hg is the symbol of which metal? Do you remember something? Hg means what? Mercury. Hg means what? Mercury. Do you heard this word, the mercury, where it is found? You know, in the thermometer. Okay, thermometer we use to measure the temperature. In that thermometer, if you will see, the red color liquid is there. Okay, that is known as a mercury. So it is in which state? It is in normal temperature. In room temperature, it is found in liquid state. So only the mercury and gallium, one more it is there. These two examples are exceptions. Mostly all metals are found in solid state. Exceptions, Hg, liquid, and you know this mercury, it is found in a thermometer. Okay, means thermometer we used, this mercury we use in a thermometer. And related to the non-metals, see, non-metals mostly are in solid and gaseous state. See, non-metals, if you will see, in the metals mostly are in solid state. Only the exception is mercury and gallium also. And in non-metal, non-metals are mostly are in solid and gaseous state. Example, sulfur. Okay, sulfur in solid state. Then hydrogen, nitrogen, these are gases. Okay, so all non-metals are found in solid and gaseous state. Here also some exceptional cases there. See here, exceptional, that is bromine. Okay, it is in a liquid state. Bromine is in a liquid state. Okay, so this is the first property of metal and non-metal. Which is the first property of metal and non-metal? Physical state. Read carefully notes, and after this lecture you have to write this all the points in your notebook. Okay, so first is a physical state. Mostly metals are in a solid state. Exception, mercury. Non-metals are in solid and gaseous state. Exception, bromine. Okay, now the second property that we will see, that is a luster. Luster means what? Luster means shine. Okay, luster means what? Shine. All metals are lustrous. Lustrous means they all are having shine. For example, see, Au. Au means what? Tell me, Au means gold. See, gold we are wearing. We are using these golds to make jewelries. Okay, silver. These all are metals, and they all the metals are having shine. Okay, so mostly all metals, but in that some metals are having more shine and some are non-lustrous. Means, for example, that is the sodium. So actually sodium is also lustrous, but it is a, because it is a highly reactive, so it is kept in a kerosene, and because of that the outside layer it is the blackish layer. So it is one exceptional, that is the sodium. But if you will cut that sodium with knife, you will see sodium is also having the luster. Okay, so mostly all metals are lusterous. Now non-metals are do not have shine. Non-metals do not have shine. For example, wood. You know, no, wood is having a shine. Wood is there. Okay, the non-metals mostly they do not have shine. Exception graphite. Graphite, you know, graphite is a pencil. Pencil, which one we are using to draw some things, some drawings for diagrams. Okay, that pencil, in that the graphite is used. So graphite is lustrous. Graphite is having shine. It is a lustrous. So it is the exceptional case. Exceptional case. Okay. So the property, that is the malleability. See, malleability means what? When metals are beaten, converted into thin sheet. Okay, when any metal, if we will beat, then it will converted into a thin sheet. That property is known as a malleability. Okay, for example, see aluminium foil, you know that if we are using it. Okay, so why? Because it is having the property, that is the malleability. Because of that, the metals can converted into a thin sheet, that is known as a malleability. For example, Ag, silver, okay, then Au, etc., gold, silver, copper. If anything, if you will take the iron, these all are the malleable, means they shows the property malleability. It means that if you will beaten, that means beaten and converted into a thin sheet, if it will convert into the thin sheet, that is only known as a malleability. Okay, but non-metals are non-malleable. Means for example, chalk and wood. If you start the beating on wood, okay, then it will convert into thin sheet? No, it will, you will make the small piece of that wood. If you will take the chalk and if you start the beating to the chalk, then it will convert into thin sheet? No. Why? Because it is a non-metal and it does not show the property of malleability. Okay, so non-metals are non-malleable. Now the next fourth physical property that we will see, that is the ductility. Ductility means what? See, the capacity of the metal to be drawn into wire. The capacity of the metal to drawn into wire is known as a ductility. Okay, so mostly all the metals, they shows this property, ductility. For example, gold, copper, silver, these the same examples are there. They are showing the ductility property. They converted into thin sheet. If you will take the jewelries and see the design which they prepare, okay, so for that, first they are the preparing what the one wire, and see in the electricity, these all the gadgets, what the copper we used. Okay, so copper wire, we know that because copper is a metal, and these all the metal shows the ductility property, and because of that they can convert into the thin wire. So here it is the similar, but the malleability means it converted into a sheet, and ductility means it converted into a thin wire. These two words you have to remember it. Okay, and the non-metal, these are not ductile, means they are not showing this the property. They don't have this property. They are non-ductile. They cannot converted into a thin wire. Okay, now the next fifth one property that we will see, that is the conductors. Now conductor means what? They conduct electricity and heat. Okay, conductors, they are means metals. These all the metals are good conductor of electricity and heat, and non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. See, they are good conductor of heat and electricity, so we are using copper wire in electric gadget. Why? Because they conduct the electricity, they allow to pass the electricity through them. Okay, so mostly all the metals, they are good conductor of heat and electricity. The best conductor of electricity is silver. Which is the best conductor of electricity? Silver. But commonly, mostly we are using a copper wire. Why? Because the silver is very costly. Okay, silver is costly, so we are wearing copper in electric gadgets. Okay, so but best conductor of electricity is silver. So conductors, metals are good conductor of heat and electricity, and non-metals are bad conductor of heat and electricity. So if you will see in the electric switches, the outside cover, it is made up of the plastic. Why? It is a bad conductor of electricity. It not allowed to conduct heat and electricity, so it is made up of plastic. So this is the next property of our physical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay, now the next one, sixth one, it is there, that is the sonority. Okay, sonorous means what? Mostly all metals are sonorous, means they produce sound. Okay, sonority means what? They produce sound. Mostly all metals produce sound. Then they shows the sonority property, and non-metals are not produce sound. So see, you heard the school bell. Okay, school bell, it is a made up of wood or plastic? No, because wood and plastics are non-metals. Okay, so school bell, it produces the sound. Why? Because it is made up of metals. Okay, ringing bell means any. So if you will take the glass and if you will beat with any hammer or you take any spoon, then see, it produces sound. So sonority, mostly all the metals are produce sound, and non-metals, they not show the sonority properties. Okay, so today we discuss the physical properties of metals and non-metals. Total 6 physical properties we learn today. Okay, these all the notes you have to write in your notebook. Okay, then chemical properties we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.